I want people to be very weary. Those who work in corporations, large corporations in particular, where, you know, they might have over 100 staff in a complex. If you're an individual that's of integrity and honour, and you're a very honest person, don't be surprised that you might get fired from a company and half the time you don't even know what happened. Well, here's the thing. Corruption has gotten to a level today which is probably through the roof, especially in countries where the economy's not doing too well. So people are going to lie, cheat, steal. They're going to do all sorts of things. Yes, we know that politicians are psychopaths. And it seems like all the psychopaths who are wealthy go to business school, and the psychopaths who are poor end up going to jail. You'll find that you'll get a job through an agency, which is the way most people get jobs these days. So you go to an agency, you give them your resume, you tell them what sort of work you require. And usually those agencies have got affiliation with the managers. That's how it's done. So the manager's got a connection through the agency. And also this connection that the consultants of the agencies have with managers, it's also something that they use for a personal gain too, because later on down the track when they need to leave the job and get a new job, they'll look after them. Because if a manager goes through one agency and hires 10 or 15 people, that agency makes a lot of money. So just there, rest assured, there's kickbacks, okay? There's more than enough managers out there who are getting handouts or having favours done for that work that they're bringing in for that agency. Because when people work for a corporation, when they're a manager, they don't care. Corporations have got billions. So what if they scam them? That's what they do. I've worked in a few corporations over the years, and high-end places too. But what I found, and fortunate for me, I've got a keen eye, is I watched the managers, and there used to be like a group, a boys group or an in-club, you know, an inner sanctum. And for instance, I was working for one firm, which was Technology Mob, and they would sell computer software and also everything related to office supplies. And we'd have meetings, and I noticed that whenever we'd ask what would the sales be at the end of the month, we'd actually have a competition to see who got it. Everybody would boost up the sales and state that the sales would be, you know, 180,000 next month, 200,000. And I'd always be looking at the figures and go, no, I'd say 110, I'd say 100, I'd say 90,000. I'd say a reduced figure. I'd actually state that the level of growth would actually reduce by 10 to 15%. Guess what? I was always right. Now, why is that? Because I understood something. I thought to myself, why are they boosting it up? Right, what these managers would do, whether it be marketing or the statisticians or the production guys, is after being there for quite a few years, what they'd done is organized side businesses. So what they did is they put the businesses in friends' names of people that was very difficult for them for their bosses to align them with, and organize supply companies to that corporation where they were working. So when this product was initially coming in from one supplier, a Chinese supplier based in Melbourne, they thought, hang on, what we'll do, we'll get this guy out of the way and we'll organize our own supply companies under our cousin's name or our good friend's name and buy from them. All right, what was the advantage of this? Well, all of a sudden they had a business outside of their job, which most of them were earning over $100,000 a year. So the beauty with this was every time there was a meeting stipulating how a certain a certain business was going in a suburb, and they were quite big buildings. They're almost the size of warehouses. They would always talk them up and say, "Oh no, they're great." And I got a sniff through the accounts people that they were fudging the figures, and the CEO had no idea. So what they do is make out that certain stores in certain areas located around Melbourne, whether it be north, east, west, south, were making more money than what they actually were. Why was this? They wanted to show that the bottom line was really good, and that way whenever the CEO say, "Oh, it's time to open up another store," they say, yeah, it's time to open up another store. Why is that? Because they would supply that store, and it meant anywhere from $10 to $15 million more product they'd have to sell the company. You know, and their jobs were secure because another store was opening, and yet the other companies that they were secret partners in would make even more. So it was amazing because you'd go at lunchtime, you'd go in the car park, you never saw a car under $150,000, you know. It just surprised. Anyway, and what happened was I understood that through what was going on in accounts is the accounts people were never kept for longer than 3 to 4 months, some 6 months max. The smart ones were let go really quick. They tended to be on like 2 month contracts. Some of them were actually on 1 month contracts, something that, you know, is just ridiculous in Melbourne. But none of them hung around more than 6 months. Why is that? Because they would get the arse, they'd get sacked. Only the dumb ones would hang out up to six months. The smart people would get the arse. Why? Because they started to understand that something's going astray here. The figures don't add up. And as soon as they start approaching one of their accounts managers, because there was a few different departments, then the word would get out, "Hey, so-and-so in accounts, the new guy or the new girl has got a sniff of what's going on. We don't want this to get out." So they'd get the arse. So here's a good person who in all realms of what it is to be a good worker, was doing all the right thing, coming to work on time, being cordial, very good team player. All of a sudden they'd be out of work and they wouldn't even know what's going on. They'd go home and argue with their husbands or wives, "Oh, you're too abrasive, this, that." It's because they didn't understand the game. They weren't smart enough to get it quick and just go along with whatever bullshit was headed their way. As soon as they started asking questions, that's it. They, within 2 weeks of asking those questions, they lost their jobs. Now, this occurs in almost every industry, okay? No matter what corporation, no matter what industry, managers get themselves in those positions, and then they tend to form all sorts of corruption right across the board. And because they all unite, and it's smart to unite, so therefore when they fill out the reports for the CEO, they all look good, okay? They don't have any rogue managers there, and everybody stays happy. And then they go on barbecue with their kids together on the weekends. They go snow. They go to the ski. They go skiing in the snow every when winter comes up. They even go away to Bali in Australia, where everybody tends to go. They tend to go to Bali together, family, you know, 4 or 5 families tend to go together. And they're smart, though, because at work they hide the photos, the vacation photos. They never show the shots of them all together. And this is how they operate. So I want people to understand that if you're a good individual, you're a nice person, and you can't work out why you're getting fired from companies, and you're in an area of the industry which is usually accounts, or even if you're bottom-up marketing and that, and you can't work out why you're losing your job, and you're not having any luck, it's because the boys up top are playing you. They're playing you like dominoes, okay? Be wary of this. And this is for all the nice people out there. Just be wary. And it's a shame, because what they're telling you in those industries is your best to hear no evil, see no evil, speak no evil. Sad. And that's corruption in our world today, and people are selling out for money. And it's not that they sell out for money. Okay, people want to make money to survive and so forth, but they're making more than enough. There's those individuals in positions of power who'll make it more than enough, and others have to suffer as a result. And that's disgusting. And I want you to understand what I just said, okay, and analyze it. Thanks.